The 16 bodies recovered today included three children as emergency workers clad in white jumpsuits exhumed their remains from shallow graves and also found two emaciated survivors. The grim discovery has sent shockwaves through the country in Kenya, prompting President William Ruto to pledge a crackdown on unacceptable religious movements.
For seven people and been confirmed dead. However, today, again, additional 11. Therefore, that makes a number of 58 people confirmed dead. And this is out of bodies exhumed and those who died on the way to the hospital.
As the fatalities mounted, authorities at the state-run Malindi Sub-County Hospital warned today that the morgue was running out of space to store the bodies and already operating well over capacity.
Okay, so what we're going to do is that we're going to...
It is believed that some followers of the Good News International Church could still be hiding in the bush around Shakahola and at risk of death if not quickly found. Hussein Khalid, the executive director of the rights group Haki Africa that tipped off the police, urged authorities to send more rescuers to the grounds to find survivors.
Still in there, who are continuing with this fast and possibly dying every second that passes by. That is why we are appealing to the national government to send boots on the ground so that we can go to the interior and rescue these victims who are, in the process of fasting till death.
Investigators say they found bodies squeezed into shallow pits with up to six people inside one grave, while others were simply left outside on the ground. Kenya's Inspector General of Police, Japhet Koome, told reporters on Monday that 29 people had been rescued and taken to hospital.
We strongly condemn any form of religious organization that promotes extremist beliefs and operates outside the confines of the law, putting the safety and well-being of Kenyans at risk and violating a basic human rights, in this case, the right to life.
We need the individuals in there, and I want to urge the judiciary to support us in this. Because the individual, the other time when we went to court, was given only a 10,000 bail and came back here and continued doing what he was doing.
Questions have emerged about how the cult was able to operate undetected despite Paul Mackenzie Mtenge attracting police attention 6 years ago. The televangelist had been arrested in 2017 on charges of radicalization after urging families not to send their children to school, saying education was not recognized by the Bible. Mtenge is currently in police custody. Uganda is no stranger to cults. In 2000, Movement for the Restoration of the Ten Commandments of God leader Joseph Chibuetere convinced over 700 believers that the world was ending. He managed to gather them into a church before setting it on fire. 6 mass graves were found on the cult land measuring up to 48 hectares. More than 280 bodies were found and recovered from these graves, bringing the total death to over 1,000. Joseph Chibuetere was never caught.